Hello, my name is Florian Wilk from CMC in Larnaca, Cyprus, Tbilisi, Georgia, and Singapore. And today I want to talk about moving from the European Union as a perpetual traveler or digital nomad around the globe, around Southeast Asia, South America, Latin America, and what is the best setup in my personal opinion to not leave the European Union directly. What could be a possible solution for your setup? And the reason why I want to talk about this is many of our clients, they are moving from Germany, Austria, France, Spain, Italy, Poland, and other European countries to Mexico or Brazil, or they are traveling around as a digital nomad, yeah, spend some time in Bali, in Thailand, Malaysia, and are all around the world, but they don't have an actual base. So what they usually do is they just deregister from their previous home country and register themselves as not resident anymore. And then they think they are done. They can just travel around, not spend anywhere more than 183 days and not be liable to pay any tax nowhere in the world. Unfortunately, it's not that simple. Obviously, it can work. I don't say there is cases where it can't work, but in my personal opinion, you need to have a solid setup, a solid structure, especially if you make some serious income. If you make more than just 1 or 2,000 euros a month, then probably it's really not that important. But if you make some serious business and have some serious income, you should really have a look into your tax structure and to make sure that you are 100% compliant and legal in whatever you're doing, and you're just not trying to go under the radar, because sooner or later such setups might not work, and then you can face huge problems like tax payments for the last 5 or 10 years, plus penalties, plus interest rates, and maybe even some additional legal problems. Yeah, so I strongly advise to get some consultation, to inform yourself and collect some opinions about your situation, especially from your home country, of course, but also for new opportunities for other countries where you can possibly become a tax resident and go around these problems in a legal and well-structured way. The setup I want to talk today about is moving to the Republic of Cyprus. They have a very nice legislation which is called the non-domiciled status, or non-dom. As a non-domiciled, it means you're becoming resident in the Republic of Cyprus. You spend there minimum 60 days per year, not more than 183 days anywhere else. Makes sense, because then you would be tax resident in that country where you spend more than 183 days. And you have a connection to the country. Usually you open a limited liability company, LTD, in Cyprus, or you could just have a permanent resident there, rent an apartment there or rent a villa there to have this economic connection with Cyprus. Yeah, you definitely need to have a residency there to spend time there. So how does it work? The first step is, after you deregistered from your home country, you closed your business there, you sold your car and quit your flat and whatever you had to do in order to leave your home country, you can rent a flat or a villa, apartment in Cyprus. We help you to find something if you require help. I can also recommend real estate agents. Then you apply for the yellow slip. The yellow slip is the official document from the Republic of Cyprus, which means that you're becoming a tax resident. That was not actually correct, that you're becoming a resident of Cyprus. It means yellow slip means you have a residence, you have an address in Cyprus, and in the next step, you can become a tax resident. It means you can apply for a tax number for you. And with your personal tax number, you can use it for banks. Yeah, banks often ask for your tax number. They want to know where is your tax residency. Yeah, and nowadays we have the common reporting standard. It means there is exchange of information nearly all over the world, and wherever you go in the world and open a bank account or a broker account or whatever it is, you usually are asked to provide your personal tax number. Yeah? And with your yellow slip, in the second step, you can apply for the personal tax number. Of course, we can take care of these things for you to deal with the bureaucratic side in the Republic of Cyprus. And to become a tax resident there, you should spend normally 183 days in Cyprus, but with the non-domiciled, you can become tax resident in Cyprus and exempt from your special contribution for defense, which is a tax on capital income, yeah, like interest, like sale of stocks and other financial products, yeah, and also dividends, of course. It means when you're having a company in Cyprus, for example, you pay your 12.5% corporate income tax in Cyprus, then you distribute dividends to yourself as a shareholder. You don't pay any tax on those dividends. You're tax exempt. The only it's not a tax, it's a health contribution you have to pay is 2.65%, which is kept at an income of 180,000 euros per year. It means you pay maximum around 4,000 euros per year for this national health system, NHS, and this is the only personal tax obligation for your capital income. Of course, if you want to have a deeper look in your tax situation, it's always good to have a personal meeting and to discuss your different sources of income. If you have maybe rental income from abroad, if you have as an individual entrepreneur somewhere in the world income, if you want to restructure those income sources, yeah, and especially also to have a look on the perspective of your home country, yeah, to be compliant with the local tax laws, yeah, CFC rules, especially when you are leaving the country, yeah, to make sure that everything is structured in a proper way. So let me summarize this structure. At the end of the day, when you are leaving your home country, you're becoming a resident in the Republic of Cyprus. We can help you to take care of the residence of the yellow slip application, so you become officially a resident in the Republic of Cyprus. In the next step, you get your tax number, and then when you spend minimum 60 days in Cyprus, you can get your non-domiciled paper confirmation from the tax authorities. Actually, the Ministry of Finance is issuing this document, and then you are exempt from special contribution for defense for 17 years. So you really have a long period of time you can plan with. Yeah, you can spend a lot of time in Cyprus, many years in Cyprus. And in the meantime, if you are spending your 60 days in Cyprus and you might use the rest of the year to travel around, to go to South America, to Southeast Asia, or anywhere in the world, you have a really lot of time to do that. Yeah, because you have only to spend this 60 days in Cyprus minimum. And later on, if you decide to become tax resident in Georgia or in Panama, in Paraguay, in Thailand, in Indonesia, Malaysia, Hong Kong, Singapore, Dubai, one of those interesting countries, also from the taxation point, yeah, and from the lifestyle point of view, then of course you can leave Cyprus anytime and do this additional step. But the idea, the main idea behind this step to Cyprus first within the European Union and then to move abroad internationally is to make it easier for you from your tax structure, especially when you're traveling, to have still a base in the European Union, to have still one foot in the European Union, to have a tax residency in the European Union, and to have a personal tax number, to have a residency, because maybe you have faced such problems before. If you are nowhere registered, if you are living nowhere, if you don't have a tax number, it is extremely hard, nearly impossible, to open and maintain bank accounts, yeah, to receive client payments and so on and so forth, because the banks of course have strict compliance regulations. They are obliged to ask you for such things, and if you cannot provide a tax number or a residence certificate or things like that, usually you can not open an account. There might be exemptions, but in 99% of the cases, without a proper residence, you will sooner or later face problems with your existing banks, and also it will be extremely hard to open new bank accounts, and it can also affect your business, of course. So if you want to have a closer look into such structures, if you are interested to leave the European Union, to move abroad, but you're not sure which country yet, you want to travel around to decide, yeah, maybe for a few years, but you still want to have a base in the European Union, I can strongly advise you to have a closer look into Cyprus. It's in my personal opinion the most attractive jurisdiction for tax purposes, for your personal tax status, but also for company, by the way, in the European Union. And yeah, just visit us in Larnaca, or you can just call me for a free 15-minute first consultation, and we can have a look into your personal setup. We have also a wide network of international tax advisors, lawyers in Malta, Netherlands, Portugal, Germany, Austria, Poland, Thailand, Emirates, Georgia, all over the world, basically in most interesting jurisdictions at least, and I'm sure we can help you with your personal setup. Thank you very much for your attention. Please subscribe to my channel, like the video, and I would be very happy if you share this video with your friends, business partners who might be interested in such a setup or a similar setup. I want to have at least 10,000 subscribers till end of the year, and would be very glad if you help me to reach that aim. Thank you very much. Have a great day. Yours, Florian Wilk.